I'm Dr. T, and welcome to my office. And today I'd like to talk about a couple of interesting fish dishes. Yes, we're talking food. So the first one is ceviche. Ceviche is a traditional dish found in lots of Spanish-speaking cultures. It's going to start out as your choice of either white fish or shrimp, and some assorted vegetables. Now, the reason that this is distinctly different than, say, any other fish dish is that, like sushi, it's not cooked. Well, I should say it's not heated to a particularly high temperature. And caveat, sushi is sometimes cooked. But back onto the fish. Okay, so ceviche is cooked. And I definitely use the quotes because it's not a true cooking. It is cooked by the addition of acids, typically things like lime juice. This is going to react with the proteins. See, the proteins on the fish, or in the fish, are comprised of amino acids, and some of which are weak acids and weak bases. Now, what do I mean by weak acid or weak base? These are molecules that are capable of either accepting or receiving hydrogens, like any old acid or base would, but unlike the classic strong acid or strong bases, which simply donate their proton or accept a proton and don't look back, weak acids and weak bases create an equilibrium with proton and without proton, or protonated and deprotonated. So because of this, you can actually do some rather interesting things. When it comes to proteins, like that making up the fish, you will start to distort and disrupt the nature of the protein, rearrange its configuration, a process known as denaturation, if you do things such as add heat to it or change the charge on its amino acids. And of course, when an acid gives off a hydrogen, it becomes an anion, and when a base accepts a hydrogen, it becomes a cation or is no longer an anion. Well, you've now changed the charge on the amino acids, and therefore it rearranges the fish, and thus it is mostly cooked. Although, once again, the quote part is because certain pathogens can survive the acid bath. That is actually why you have acid in your stomach. It's to convert anything you eat into ceviche and hopefully kill most of the things that could hurt you. So, once again, most of the things, not everything. Therefore, make sure you get your ceviche fish from a reputable dealer. That said, it's a delicious dish. Absolutely strongly recommend it. Now, there's another counterpart, more common to northern climates, Scandinavian and I believe British, although I'm not entirely sure on this one, nor am I entirely sure how you pronounce it. It appears to be spelled something like lutefisk or luckfish. And in this case, we do very much the same thing as ceviche, but instead of treating it with acid in order to cook the fish, we instead use base, and this results in a noticeably different texture since, you know, you're kind of doing the opposite scrambling of the proteins. A dish I haven't had, I have not heard particularly good reviews for it, but some people definitely like the dish. Now, when we're talking about acids or bases, it's useful to discuss, well, is it a weak acid or a strong acid, and how weak? Because you can imagine there would be things that would give up their proton completely, other ones that will accept it back, you know, sometimes, and still others that will just give or take, etc. Likewise for the bases. Well, for that, we have an equilibrium constant, because this is an equilibrium reaction if you're dealing with a weak acid or weak base. Therefore, it's going to be K. But with equilibrium reactions, we quite often put a subscript with that K to indicate what it's the K of. So for acids, we have Ka, and for bases, we have Kb. These are basically just a normal equilibrium constant, except for that we are dealing with an acid, and these are of such importance that, hey, we're going to deal with it. Thus, a very large Ka, like any other equilibrium constant, equals a reaction that's very greatly shifted towards products, and thus would indicate that the acid is a very strong acid, whereas a small Ka would indicate that the acid is fairly weak. The difference between these can actually be enough that instead of talking about Ka, we'll talk about pKa, where the lowercase p indicates that we've taken the negative log, so that we don't have to deal with all of those annoying zeros, because these are different by multiple powers of 10. So with that said, have a wonderful day. If you have a chance to try some ceviche, I strongly recommend it.